Okay, this next story has all of us going, ah. A house filled with rats is getting attention tonight in St. Petersburg. Yes, rats.
Yeah, rats. We first told you about this a couple of weeks ago. Now the city is moving in to catch all of these rats, but there are hundreds of these rats to deal with. And Jeff Patterson is joining us now live in St. Petersburg. And Jeff, you went inside the home today for a firsthand look. I saw you. I didn't think you were going into surgery, but you had protection, didn't you?
I know.
As a matter of fact, a rat has decided to join us live on the eve up there, Keith. I don't know. He might have ducked back in, but now imagine going inside of this home and hearing this sound going off all around you. That's the sound of a rat being caught in a trap. Now, we're not going to show you any dead rats tonight because we know that you might be eating, but some of the scenes you're about to see are still pretty gruesome.
I can hear them in the ceiling.
With the permission of the family that owns the home, we went inside.
So they're in the walls too, right?
They're everywhere.
We went in with Laura Spaulding, who specializes in dealing with and cleaning up situations involving hoarders.
There's a live one right here. It's huge.
We saw live rats and plenty of dead ones.
We've got traps set everywhere.
Rat droppings are everywhere.
And this is the kitchen. There's another dead one.
No spot in the kitchen is untouched by rats.
I can smell the ammonia.
The ammonia.
Frankly, it's all I can do not to throw up right now.
When Laura opened a drawer for us.
Yep, look at that.
There you go.
We found a live rat just sitting there. Right. And upstairs, conditions are even worse.
This is a house of hoarders. They're living in there, and she's sleeping right here.
The city is setting traps to catch the rats, but it's not an easy process.
At some point, you catch all that you can catch, and the rats are very intelligent creatures, and they become trap shy, and you won't catch anymore. So you'll still have some remaining. At that point, one of our options is to tent the home, and we're looking at that.
The house belonged to Lonnie Coleman's parents. His niece has been living here.
I've been consistently trying to get her to do something about this problem.
After the rats are eradicated, Laura Spaulding's company will try to clean things up.
So basically everything that's in here is going to have to be trashed.
Absolutely. Everything's contaminated in here.
Yeah, we just saw two very large rats come down the side of the house there. We've talked to some of the neighbors around here. They're saying they're starting to see them come out of the home, run across the power line. So it's obviously a problem for this neighborhood. The city tells us it may take a couple of weeks to clean this up. Reporting live in St. Petersburg, Jeff Patterson, News Channel 8.